combined paintings also, chitrakalas. So what I thought was I would sing a few songs and then I would proceed with my paper and then I would connect the songs that I'm singing with the paper. And these are songs to the goddess, and the reason that I have picked these particular songs which are to the goddess is one of the most important aspects of the Sanskrit storytelling tradition is how much we have honored and respected the goddess. And it has been done traditionally, and no other culture has been women and the goddess been so as honored as in India. And for women, when we want to tell stories for children and stories for girls, stories that inspire girls, we must tell the stories of the goddess. So I'm just starting with a few songs and then I will proceed with my paper.
Relationship. The Guru-Shishya system
thereby a qualified teacher of the great knowledge of the Vedas, art, architecture, philosophy, spirituality. The student used a lot of storytelling. Stories were thus used to serve an educational purpose. Stories were often passed on through the Guru Shishya Parampara, the offline chain of mystic power. Gurus traditionally use stories to answer basic questions about world, life and existence. Who created this world? Why is there misery in life? How can one's life be improved? Are there any powers behind this manifesting existence? What is the ideal ethical conduct one must adopt to live in this world? Is there a hereafter and how can it be attained? What is the purpose of life? A great many of the Indian sages and mystics such as Ramana Maharishi were natural storytellers. Stories became the means through which they conveyed their special messages to their disciples who were frequently children. Through stories, they would present intuitive knowledge about the nature of the highest of reality, which was otherwise incapable of being understood or expressed.
The number of goddess names
are found in the Vedas, and in the stories about the goddess, they have primary position in both classical and folk narratives. In Soundarya Lahari by Adi Shankaracharya, the goddess Tripurasundari is depicted as the supreme power in the universe, and this is how her power over all including the Trinity is established in Sanskrita Bala-Sahitya Brahma collects a minute particle of dust from the goddess's feet and creates the wondrous, limitless, and infinitely mysterious universe. The world is sustained by Adishesha, an ancient serpent in the form of Vishnu, who supports the universe with his thousand dwell pools. The world is destroyed, and Shiva takes the universe made out of the dust of the goddess's feet and crushes it into sacred ashes, which he smears all over his body. The Devi Bhagavata Purana, one of the great Puranas devoted exclusively to the goddess, emphasizes that the energy that creates all the universe and permeates is of the supreme goddess, at whose command the universe vibrates. Devi Mahatmyam or Chandipa, the fourth part of the Mahakanya Purana, describes the victory of the three-eyed, blind-eyed goddess Durga over the buffalo demon Mahishasura. These stories provided great inspiration to girls. Radical personal change and social change will become possible with the child.